Hi, I'm Pramod. So I have an experience of around 10 years in software industry. I work for a very big MNC in India. So IT Seekers or DBA. So first, let me explain you what do you mean by Seekers or DBA and what are the different opportunities you have in SQL Server. When I talk about SQL Server, so there are different openings. When you post your resume, you have different openings for SQL Server. First opportunity, there is something called developer. That is called SQL developer. And some companies will take it as SQL DBA for this event. Second role, there is something called MSBA. Third thing, there is something called actual core SQL DBA. And there is something else called application DBA. So first, before understanding or coming into this class, you need to understand what is that you are going to learn and what is that I'm going to teach you. So before that, understand. So according to market, these are the four different resumes will be available for interview. When I talk about developer, they talk only about development. That means writing, creating store processes, writing functions, T-SQL statements. They call it as SQL DBA, but in roles and responsibilities, they'll be clearly mentioning that it is mostly a development work, like as I told, like creating store processes, all these things. There's something called MSBA. This is nothing but BI tool. Here comes something called reporting services, integration services, and analysis services. This is basically for business purpose. Even this comes under development. Second category. Third category is actual core SQL DBA. And there is something called fourth called App DBA. Let me explain the difference between App DBA and core SQL DBA. When I talk about App DBA, it is mostly depending on application. That means when I'm a DBA, actual meaning of DBA is database administrator. That means I look at database. When I say app DBA, I'm more focused about application. So app DBA in turn refers application DBA. That is application DBA for application. That means my focus will be mostly on application. Like you take any product-based company like Microsoft or Deloitte. So what they have? So they have their own products, and for their internal, they have their own internal applications to manage their HR system or any other systems. So for that, you'll be supporting this. That means you are mostly supporting application, but you're expected to have DBA knowledge. Okay, so when I say here, there is a mixture of application knowledge plus DBA knowledge. 80% will be of application and 20% will be DBA knowledge. And around 5% of developer knowledge is also essential. So, but what we discuss here is basically core SQL DBA. This is the core of complete SQL. When I talk about DBA, this is what we mean. When you go to outside market and when you see your resume, so this is what actually it means. So here you are not concerned about application. So you are in a support, your database administration. That means you are administrator for different applications. So there can be 500 applications, there can be 1,000 applications, it doesn't matter to you. Only you need to understand is what is the database, what is the server name, and what do I do to resolve the issues. Simple. So this is where you focus. Here it will be 24/7 support. You'll have 24/7 support on DBA. You are not concerned about data. You are only concerned about storage, that is database. So when I say about DBA, what are the different technologies we have? What are the different steps in DBA you'll be learning in this class? And what we'll be teaching as a trainer, what is it that you'll be getting taught? So first thing, we talk about server architecture. So what is SQL Server? And what is the architecture of SQL Server? Second thing, there is something called database architecture. So for DBA, this is mostly important. And in database architecture, there are two parts. One is data architecture, and second thing is log architecture. Then comes next part, when you go inside, that is security aspect of SQL Server. So how do you log into SQL Server? How I use is added to SQL Server? How do you access SQL Server? And fourth, you talk about backups and restores. That means just imagine a scenario, somehow your database is gone, your server is gone. So how do you get the data available? Suppose you take up ICICI Bank example. So you have database for any application, you have database at the back end. So in case your database is down, that means you are accessing your account. Suddenly you found that there is a network error or some database connectivity error. So that means there's issue with the database. So you want to restore it fastly so that user will not be having any troubles. So You require a backup because in case the existing database gets corrupted, you need to restore it back. So for that, I need to take a backup and restore it. That is called backup and restore. And fifth thing, the most important thing is the thing about high availability. So here there will be a lot of options. Like we talk about clustering here. We talk about log shipping here. We talk about mirroring here. We talk about always on here. And we talk about replication here. So what do you mean by high availability? The name itself says high availability. That means your database should be available all the time, irrespective of what happens to existing, what happens to server, whatever happens, your database should be available. So for that, we have different options in SQL Server where you can make sure that your database is available always. So we'll go deeply into these topics. And six, we talk about what are the different DBA tasks. When you go into a company as a DBA, what are different activities you will be learning? What are the different activities you will be getting? So what are, how do you do a day-to-day work of a DBA? That's what we'll get, I'll teach you here. And seventh most important thing is the thing about performance tuning. So how do you tune a database? So we cover all these topics. So this is at a high level, but we'll go into depth for each topic. And this course will be taking around 30 to 40 days to complete all these topics. So let's summarize this, what we have learned today. So what we understood today is, what are the different profiles you have in a SQL Server, and what is that you are going to get taught here. So what are the different different options you have in SQL Server, and what are the things you'll be taught here. So if you want to get into details of each and every topic, come join us into Great Lakes.